Hello everyone, it's Lindsay, and today I'm going to share a new fun project with you guys that I am kind of just getting the ball rolling on. I have the newest collection from Freckled Fawn. This is October's collection. I've also pulled out some older alpha stickers and things. If you're wondering what all comes in this collection, I will link my unboxing down below. They have some new journaling cards in the shop that they're offering now, which is super, super fun. And these would be great for the project that I'm showing you today as well. These are a good size for that. So what I will be creating today is a Memory Dex card. So I have done Memory Dex cards on my channel before. I will link my Tip Tuesday down below that kind of talks about what are Memory Dex cards, what are some of the options, what does it take to create, what do you do with these. I've done a wide variety of things with Memory Dex cards. I've done them for devotional studies. I've put verses on there. I've put prayers on there. I've just made cute cards. There's all kinds of things that you can do. You can put photo memories, all kinds of things. And so recently, Heidi Swap, she's the one behind the Memory Dex craze, she released some new Memory Dex products. So I am super excited. It kind of seemed like they were phasing Memory Dex out, but we got everybody excited about it again. So they're bringing some new products. So they just released this new spinner style Memory Dex system, like an old style Rolodex. So I will link this down below. I was so excited to get this in the mail because it then allows you to see the front of the card, but then as you rotate it, you can see the back of the card as well. So you'll be able to see a front and a back. And so it's just a different way to display your cards. And what I was deciding to do with these are do some prayer cards. So I did recently share about this on one of my other channels that I create for, but I haven't shared about it here on my channel yet. So oftentimes I get prayer requests from you guys in my DMs, in my comments, in my emails. You guys are so, so sweet. I am so honored by that. It just floors me that people would reach out and ask for me to pray for them. And I do always stop and pray for people, but I wanted a way to kind of organize those, keep track of them. Because sometimes when I'm going through my DMs, I don't get to it right away. And so I want a place to where I can just sit down and intentionally pray over those prayer requests and pray for prayer requests that come from people in my church or just other things that come about that I want to pray for and that kind of thing. And so what I decided to do was to create these Memory Dex cards that have little pockets and little tuck-in and hidden places where I can stick those prayer requests. And then when I come into my office to do some prayer time, I can pull out a couple of those and do some prayers and just kind of have a way to keep track of them, but also just have a way to use pretty product. I don't know about you. I'm not taking a whole lot of photos right now with the pandemic and everything going on. And so I have a lot of product that's kind of getting built up that I'm not using in scrapbooking projects. I am using it in Bible journaling. But there's just sometimes you have pretty things that you want to create with, and maybe you don't have photos to create with. And so I want to do Memory Dex cards. That way I can use up, get that crafty outlet, use some of the things that I love and have it on display where I can see it. So my cards themselves won't always directly relate to the prayers that are tucked inside. I may just create a bunch of these all at once and just have them ready to go to stick the prayers in. I might sit down and have somebody in mind and create a card around that person. So I'm really keeping it very loose. I really just wanted an excuse to create Memory Dex cards, but then have a purpose behind them. So if you just want to create pretty cards, go for it. There is nothing wrong with that. But you could put quotes or verses or photos or things like that as well. So all that to say, I am working with the October collection from Freckled Fawn, and it's just one of those pretty collections that I really wanted to play with and have out on display. And so what better way than to make a Memory Dex card? So what I have here are the 6x8 papers, and I've already gone ahead and cut out this template. This is a Silhouette Studio file. It comes with three different envelopes that are already sized and ready to go for the Memory Dex system. So I will try to link that file number down below for you guys, but there's, you can get SVG files from Etsy, all kinds of different shops. You can even use the envelope punch board and then just punch out. So create an envelope and then just use the punch to create your holes. So please don't feel like you have to have an electronic die cutting machine to do this. I'm just trying to put my own stash to work. My Silhouette sits there and hardly ever gets used. And so I want to put that to use, but please just adapt things to what you have in your stash. So all that to say, we cut out this file. I did not manipulate the size, so it's exactly as is. And so my machine cuts this all out, gives me my score marks, and creates this fun little memory decks envelope. So I used one of those double-sided 6x8 papers, which is perfect for this because you automatically have a pattern in the inside. They are nice and thick. So with these cards, typically I'll double up papers to make sure that they're not flimsy, but I don't need to do that with these papers. It's already good to go. So this is going to give me a little envelope that I can stick a prayer in, and then we can decorate the front. Now, because of the way this system works, and you see the backside upside down. So I just need to keep in mind if I put any words or anything on the backside to do it upside down. So I've gone ahead and pulled out a few different things off camera. I went ahead and did some typing on the labels. And how I do that is I just adhere the labels to either some wax paper or just a plain piece of copy paper. This time I did it on plain copy paper and then just cut them out. So I will have to adhere them. But just put it on the copy paper, run the copy paper through my typewriter, and then typed out the phrases that I'm going to be using. So let me go ahead, put you guys on fast forward, and I will walk you through all the pieces as we put together this fun little Memory Decks prayer envelope. Okay, so I'm gonna start by gluing together my envelope and get that started. Again, you can use any cut file for this. You can create your own envelope. I think you can even find like templates online to like trace and cut, even if you don't have a die cutting machine or something like that. So don't let that stop you from creating one of these. I'm trying out some new liquid glue. I'll let you know what I think. I will have it linked down below. But I'm going to create one of these little rosettes. And I was showing you there the dyes that I'm using. They are cocoa and Reno dyes. And then this particular die, you do have to cut twice to create one of these little rosettes. And so I was showing you that when you're using a pattern paper, you want to make sure that you cut the rosette pieces from a same spot in the pattern. That way the pattern's continued all the way through the rosette. It'll make sense when I put this all together. You want it to be all the same. So I cut it from similar areas on the pattern. And then you're just accordion folding back and forth. There's a wide variety of rosette dies. There's rosette cut files. You could even just cut a strip of paper and accordion fold it back and forth, and you just wouldn't have the decorative edge, or you could get fancy with decorative scissors. Like, I'm telling you, take what I do on here and run with it, because there's so many different ways to do what I show in these videos like this. So I'm just going through an accordion folding. You do have to adhere those two pieces together, and then you adhere the two edges to make like a circle. If you've never done one of these before, I love the outcome. They're just a little tricky to work with, because you have to like hold it down. It doesn't want to stay down on its own. I was trying to see if I could use one of the circle label stickers to hold it, but that was going to be too big. So I just pulled out a small circle punch, and I'm going to punch out two circles. You don't have to do this step, but this is the easiest way to make the rosette stay, and then you can stick it to your project. So I'm using that liquid adhesive to put a circle on the back and the front. It's so much easier to do that step with hot glue. So if you're comfortable using hot glue because it sets so much quicker, that is kind of the way to do these rosettes. But I didn't want to bust out my hot glue gun, so I just used regular glue and just kind of held it together until the glue set enough that it would hold itself. And then before sticking it onto the front of my envelope, I did put a little nest of gold thread underneath that rosette piece. And then I set my stamp block on there, and I'm going to set that aside to let it kind of firm up and let the glue dry on that. And while that is happening, I'm going to work on customizing one of these wood veneer pieces. So this is from Freckled Fawn. This was in the October collection. And I love to paint my wood veneer. I don't particularly like just naked wood veneer. I like to do something to it. So I am using some distress paints. I have some tattered rose, evergreen bough, and then I'll pull out picket fence. And I'm just painting in this coffee cup to look like a coffee cup. I'm picking colors that go along with the colors from this collection. Evergreen brow is this really pretty minty green color, but it's a little bit deeper than the mint that is in the collection. So I'm just mixing a little bit of white with it to tone it down and to get that really pale mint
color, and I'll just use that to paint in the center portion. I prefer to use distress paints just because of the texture, how well they stick to any surface. They just have a lot of fun properties with them. I do believe I have a Tip Tuesday about them. If I do, I'll link it down below. They're just a really nice paint, but you could definitely do this with just regular acrylic paint. But I like that these are a little bit thinner, so I feel like I have more control of the paint and can clean up mess ups a little bit easier. So I'm just finishing it off by painting in the top of that coffee cup white, and these dry fairly quickly. And then I can go ahead and adhere this to the front of my rosette. Super cute. That's exactly what I envisioned doing with those coffee cups when I unboxed them. And so I'm super glad to have them down on a project like that, and turned out really cute. So now I can work on my little phrase over here. So when it's all put together, it's going to say, all I need is a little bit of coffee and a whole lot of Jesus. I'd like to reverse that and put Jesus before coffee, but that's just how the phrase goes. So don't come at me theologically. Yes, I know we need a lot more Jesus ahead of coffee or anything else, but that's just how the phrase goes. So I thought it was just a cute way to go along with those coffee cups. So I'm using the alpha stickers from this month's collection, and then I've pulled out some pink ones from Freckled Fawn as well. I am layering these over some of the washi that comes in this collection just to add some more texture and layers. I was kind of going for lots of clutter. I wanted it to just stick as many things as I could on the front of this little Memory Dex card. I find that the ones that I'm pinning and saving and seeing online that I like the most are the ones that just have tons of stuff on the front of them. So that's kind of what I was going for. I love those pink and gold alphas. Those are a favorite of mine. Even though they look like I haven't really been using them, it's because I'm hoarding them. Don't tell anybody, but I did use them for this project. I did add a little bit more washi down at the bottom just as a decorative element, but it does also just kind of firm up and add some additional reinforcement to the bottom of the card since it is going to be sliding along on that Rolodex system. And then just cut out any areas that were overlapping the holes. And then here are the enamel stickers from this month's collection, and I'm just going to add a few of these. Kind of trying to stick with the colors that I've already been using on this envelope here. And then to hold my envelope closed, I'm just using a glue dot, but my glue dots are super, super sticky. So I'm just kind of tapping it. I used a little bit of my powder tool just to take a little of the stickiness away. That way it would hold the envelope closed, but I could still open it and stick stuff in and take stuff out without tearing my paper. You could also do that with Velcro, like little Velcro dots. That is on my list of things to order because I plan on doing more envelope pockets like this. So this, again, is going to be upside down when it's in that Rolodex system. So I'm just adding a little bit of embellishment because you will be able to see this when this card is flipped down. So it doesn't need to be anything too crazy, but I did want to add one of those chipboard stickers, a little more washi, and then some of those enamels. And then you can see here, it'll pop right on. I can stick my prayer in there and it is good to go. So if you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave those down below. Check out the description box for links to everything that I used today. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. And until next time, thank you so much. Bye-bye.